In this video, let us discuss a theory concept called file system tunneling. I will show you a quick demo. I have a file here called fruits.txt. Let us check the creation time of the file. The creation time of the file is 8:18 p.m. Now, I will delete this file. And I will create a new text file with the same name as fruits. The current time in the system is 10:14 p.m. Let us check the creation time of this new file. Although this file was created at 10:14 p.m., it is still showing the creation time of the older fruits file. What could have caused this behavior? Let's start with file names in Windows OS. We'll consider the absolute name of a file, which is the file name dot extension along with its path names. The total number of characters in the absolute name of a file can be 32,767. Considering only the relative name of the file, file dot extension, the total number of characters allowed is 259 characters for files and 248 characters for folders. In some old 16-bit or 32-bit or 64-bit applications, only 8.3 file names were used. In 8.3 file names, 8 characters are used to specify the name of the file and 3 characters are used for the extension. New applications can handle long file names which do not exceed 259 characters for files. To allow backward compatibility with older applications, the long file name has a corresponding short file name which is in 8.3 file name form. The first 6 characters of the long file name are used, followed by a tilde symbol, and is numbered starting from 1. If there is another long file name, as the curious fox skipdinner.pdf, in its short file name representation, the first 6 characters would be the same as the previous long file name. So in this case, after the tilde symbol, the number 2 is used to name the file. The two short file names can be differentiated this way. The file system would keep a track of the corresponding long file names. If another similar long file name comes in, its corresponding short file name would get the number 3. Looking at the file's metadata, there would be a long file name, a short file name, the timestamps, file data, and security related information. If an old application has to deal with this file with a long name, what happens is, as the application can understand only 8.3 names, the file system creates a new copy of the file. Only the short name and metadata like timestamps and security information along with the file data are tunneled into the new file. The older application strips away the metadata it does not understand. The newly created file uses the timestamps tunneled to it. This means it uses the creation time of the file with the long name. This behavior of the old application is called safe save operation. current Windows systems still retain this tunneling capability. When a file is deleted, its metadata is cached for a short period of time. When a new file with the same name is created in the same path, the old file's metadata is used. However, file system tunneling currently extends to the file creation time only. Using 8.3 file names restricts the use of unique file names. You can check if your file system allows backward compatibility with 8.3 file names using fsutil tool. The status on the current volume can be checked using the administrator's command prompt. fsutil has an option called 8.3 name. This feature can be set on the volume. The volume can also be queried for usage status of 8.3 name feature. This tunneling feature, which was introduced for 8.3 file names, now extends to file creation time. Tunneling does not always happen though. You can check if tunneling is enabled on your Windows system by checking this registry key. If the value is 1, it means tunneling is enabled. If it is 0, it means tunneling is disabled. It was mentioned that when a file is deleted, its metadata is cached by the file system for a short period of time. That time duration can be specified in this registry key. The value needs to be specified in seconds. If this registry key is not present, it means tunneling is currently not active in the system. Again, to enable tunneling, this registry key can simply be created. There is a catch. This tunneling feature works only on storage devices formatted as NTFS that are part of the Windows operating system. It does not work on external storage devices like USB drives, which are formatted as NTFS. It does need a registry to dictate its behavior. When you perform forensic analysis on a storage device formatted as NTFS, used alongside the Windows operating system, you can check the registry values to find if tunneling has been enabled or not. It would be helpful to know that before analyzing timestamps.